aren't these beautiful? Those look like this.
They're cornflowers.
They're cornflowers? Yeah. Oh, they're so pretty. Wow.
What did you do before you decided to become a weaver?
Well, I've lived here, before I moved here, I was a civil engineer. And I came here about 6 years ago. And I used to bake in a cafe over there, and I worked in the village shop.
Mm-hmm. How do I feel?
The rapier gets to this end and grabs hold of it.
So it grabs it down there.
Grabs it and cuts it. There, I see. It always cuts at this end. Okay, uh-huh. It cuts the previous thread, if you like, and then it's pulling it directly off the comb. Like that. Okay.
That's beautiful.
So this is the warp. Yes. The frames, the threads running in this direction. Okay, that are threading through the headholes here. Okay.
Oh, I see. Okay.
And the weft are the threads we're weaving in. Okay.
Okay.
And this thing, okay, that's called a rapier, that thing on the end, okay?
Okay. Rapier. Yeah. That's okay.
You might have seen the traditional loom, which is a shuttle, which usually has a shuttle on it, okay?
Yeah.
The difference between a rapier loom and a shuttle loom is that the shuttle loom carries the yarn with it on a bobbin, okay, and carries it backwards and forwards, whereas a rapier loom doesn't carry any of the thread with it. Okay. So we've got. You can see in the mirror over there. The brown cone and the green cone and the light grey cone.
Oh, sure.
Okay. So that's the wool for the weft threads, which are the ones we're weaving in mm-hmm. in this direction. Like this. So I pedal slowly. Okay. So,
and you've only been doing this a few years?
2 years.
That's amazing.
2 years part time as well, actually. So. Sorry, I've got a now doing that.
How long have people been weaving using this
this bicycle pedaling way? This loom is about 25 years old.
Okay.
And it was made specifically for the Harris Tweed industry in the Outer Hebrides.
Wow.
And it kind of in the early 1990s, it was written into law. Harris Tweed became a protected product. So to be made in the Outer Hebrides, so Harris, Lewis, North Lewis, South Lewis, in the weaver's own home and without the use of electricity. And the traditional Harris Tweed loom, is called a Hassinin loom. It's half this width, it's treadle powered, and it has a shuttle on it. The company that make these were asked to develop a loom that would do a double width of cloth and be a bit more efficient mm-hmm. as well. So they developed this loom and then they added the pedal with the pedal power as well.
Gotcha.
So it would still comply with Harris Tweed regulations. And so that's Roger and Andre, they bought it from over in Lewis and brought it over about six years ago.
And who did you apprentice under? Who did you figure this out? Who taught you?
Oh, Roger and Andrea, they're teaching me. So they weren't weavers when they set the business up either. They had a very knowledgeable friend who helped them set the loom up and everything, but apart from that, they just learned mostly by making mistakes.
That's how we are.
And a bit of trial and error, but I mean also by studying as well. So you can see, I was explaining before about the warp threads being attached to these headles and the headles being attached to these frames here like this. So in this weave we're doing, there are always two frames up and two down. Okay? So in any set of four warp threads, for the moment there'll be two up and two down like that, okay, the weft thread passes through like that, then that one will go down, that one will come up, the weft thread passes through, that one goes down, and that one goes up like that. So, see now the back two are up, I'll pull that thread through, the back one goes down, and that one comes up, that one goes down, and that one goes up like that. And then back to where we started. So what that means is we're going over two, under two, over two, under
I see.
Two, and you're getting this. Can you see this kind of diagonal?
Oh yeah, sure. Right, are you using one of those cards over there for this type
yeah,
of...
Yeah, what we're... Okay, so...
Oh look, Doug, here's the cards.
In this piece we've got three different colours in the weft, okay? Mm-hmm. All threaded through these arms here, and they have pegs on the bottom like that,
oh,
okay?
See.
So we have a pattern cut. So each pick, which is once across the loom, that drum rotates forward one, like that. And these arms fall into the hole, like that. Okay, so in this case, we're doing 120 of the grey colour It puts two of the black colour in, and then it moves on to the green.
Awesome.
And that's all done by that pattern card. Then we've got loads on the back wall.
Gotcha.
There are 1,456 warp threads in this piece. Okay.
Wow.
And can you see how they're all wound onto?
Oh yeah.
Here, like this. Okay. So at the start, each one of these threads was 135 meters long. Okay.
So how did you get that on there?
Yeah. Well, if you come next door with me, I'll show you.
Okay. Okay?
Yeah. You staying on Skye?
Yes.
Yeah, where at?
Or tree.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
This is amazing. With the way it's been built out. My kids will love this.
Okay, yeah, so this is called the creel, okay? And when we, as you see, we buy the wool, it comes wound onto cones like this. And basically what we do, you put the cones on the creel in the order that we want them to be in the wool. Okay, and as I explained, there are 1,456 threads in that wall next door. Obviously we can't get that many cones on here at once. So what you have to do is wind from here onto this thing here. This is called a warp mill. And we wind from here onto that in sections. So in this case we had a 100. There are 100 cones, or were 100 cones on there. And 100 threads that go through here like this. And they were all... What's happened to my little knife that I use for this, so I'll just do it by hand. Okay, so imagine all those 100 threads threading through like this one. I'll just do this bit. What we do is start at this end like this. Tie a little knot in the end of the section, like that. Hook it onto that peg like that, okay, and then just turn the warp mill like this, okay. And you can see how that draws the yarn off there. Wow. And lines it onto here.
Perfect.
Okay. Yeah, so for a piece that's 135 metres long, that's 30 turns. Okay, that's 4.5 metres.
So there's some math involved.
There's quite a bit of math, a surprising amount of math involved actually, yeah.
My kids will hate to know that.
very useful math involved. We cut the piece off like that, took it in here, and then move this along, and then do the next section, and then the next section, and then the next section like that, okay? And so we've gone all the way along, we've got all the threads we want, they're all in the right order as well, and then they're all the same length as well. From the back of a tractor.
Is it?
And Roger and his friend, they rescued it from a farmyard, and they built this.
So it's a repurposed tractor rig.
It is, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Because everything's repurposed. These are floorboards and bicycle parts.
Yeah, I see the bicycle part. I see the.
Oh yeah, that's amazing.
So once this is full, we'll finish the piece next door. Mm-hmm. So then the beam you saw at the back, that'll be empty then, okay? And that comes off the back of the loom, and sits in here, and then we can wind from there onto the beam. Like
amazing.
That. And then take it back next door, and then set the loom up. Like
lovely.
I think I'll cut this off, because we need to take this off the roll. But then I can come and show you a little bit more about how things are set up and everything once we've done that.
Oh, you're cutting off.
Make sure I put this in the right, make sure I put this in the right place. That's quite scary, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Assuming you tie those ends, or you run it through a machine, or?
So no, well, that's what we do when we're setting up the warp. We don't have to tie these in. I'll just carry straight on doing the last third of the roll. Once I've cut this off, I'll take this roll inside.
Mm-hmm.
We'll take this roll inside, we'll go through it, we'll mend any mistakes or anything. Or any knots in the water and things like that. And then the whole roll goes to a factory in Gal Shields.
Oh, yeah?
In the Borders. And they're a finishing mill, so they will
finish it.
They will wash it and shrink it and comb it and brush it before it's sent back to us. If it, because at the moment it's still quite, it's thin and fairly coarse. Mm-hmm. When it comes back to us, it'll be a lot thicker and softer.
Yeah. You can see the process.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. What's going on?
You don't want him to do that? I can do it.
Yeah. She commits me to many things.
It's a beautiful color too.
How's it going? He's going first, don't I? Got to be the right way around.
Finishing
now. Oh, we haven't got that. Crucial steps.